Close the cPanel file manager if it is still open, and return to the cPanel homepage. From the cPanel homepage, click the MySQL database icon. In the New Database text field, type a name for the database, then click the Create Database button. Once the database has been created, click Go Back in the Results page. It is important to note that cPanel adds the account username and an underscore character to all database names and database user accounts that are created. Remember this when the Elgg web installer prompts you for the database name and the database user account. Next, create an account that has access to the database. In the current user section, type a username and password, then click Create User. On the results page, click Go Back. The final database task is to grant the new user privileges to the database. In the Add Users to Your Database section, select the user and database. By default, privileges are set to all. Once selected, click Add User to Database. Again, from the results screen, click Go Back. Now that the database has been created and a user account has access to the database, make sure you note the database name, username, and password you configured. You will need this information for the Elgg web-based installer. Now it's time for the Elgg installation final steps. In your browser address bar, type the address of your new social network website. The Elgg web installer first prompts you for database settings. On this page, use the database settings from the previous step. Once you have entered the database and database user credentials, fill in the database host name if it's not filled in for you. Since our database is located on the same host as the web server, localhost should work. If not, contact your hosting provider for this information. Press the Save button when you are done. Once completed with the database settings page, you will be prompted for system settings. From this page, you can configure the name of your site, provide a description, and an email address for the main site contact. The Elgg installer will attempt to fill in the site URL and full path to the Elgg files for you. If these settings do not look correct, you can alter them. The last setting you must change is the path to the Elgg data directory. The data directory for this tutorial was created outside the www directory, as shown in the text field. Review the remaining settings and configure them as necessary. Once completed, click Save. Now the web installation is complete. It's time to configure the first user for your new site. The first user you create will have administrator privileges. Once registered, you can now log in and start using your new social network site. The final step in the installation of Elgg is to correct the engine folder permissions. Log back into your cPanel account if it's not currently open. Then from the cPanel homepage, click the File Manager icon. In the File Manager, navigate to where you extracted the Elgg files. For this tutorial, it's the www directory. Click the Engine Folder Name link, and in the top right-hand corner of the page, click Change Permissions. Uncheck Write Permissions for Group and World, then click Change. If you need help with your installation or would like to customize your Elgg social network site, come visit us at elgexchange.com.